Recently, I picked up the Vidpro SK-22 Professional Skater Dolly. The idea is that the rolling wheels helps to keep the camera steady while moving the camera, such as with a pan, dolly, or truck. This motion, when done correctly, can create dramatic visuals for your movies. I've already been using it to create some Photix TV videos. Have you noticed which ones use the effect? The reason I picked up this camera gadget was to create better looking videos for you to watch. Do you see how I'm trying to hold the camera steady here? It's a little wobbly. Ironically, I needed the Vidpro Skater Dolly to record the Vidpro Skater Dolly. With a maximum capacity of 25 pounds or 11.34 kilograms, the SK-22 is designed to carry heavier cameras. In other words, it works with digital single lens reflex cameras, DSLR. But I primarily use my iPhone. If you're planning to do the same thing, it's important to know that the smartphone mount was not included. Once it's set up, it looks really cool, kinda like a camera robot, but the Vidpro Skater Dolly is totally manual. There are no electronics here. That's good because I don't have to worry about dead batteries. But that can also be a problem, as using the SK-22 is a bit of an art form. You need skill to use it. Do you see how this shot is a bit wobbly and out of focus? Also, the path is not straight. It can be tricky to get the look you're looking for. That's why this video also includes tips to help you get better shots with the Vidpro Skater Dolly. Tip number one is to try shooting at different speeds. Here's the same shot, but with slow motion turned on. That's 240 frames per second. It looks so dramatic, like a car commercial or a Hollywood movie. All it needs is some music and explosions.
Cybertruck, coming to your home sometime in the future. Perhaps 2023, or maybe 2024.
The video still has some imperfections, as there is a bit of camera shake, but it's less noticeable with slow-mo. That leads to tip number two, flat surfaces only. And what you might consider flat, and what the Skater Dolly considers flat, could be two wildly different things. Here I was trying to get a dramatic shot of the highway, but as soon as I moved the camera, it was obvious that it wasn't going to work. Sidewalks are not smooth enough, neither is asphalt. Just look at this setup. That is some serious camera shake. But who needs a motor when you have gravity? Bump. If you can find some metal that's wide enough, that could work. Here's an example of that. This looks like it could be the intro to a new TV series.
Baywatch, Staten Island.
But the reality is that I usually use the Vidpro SK-22 indoors. Much to the dismay of Fluffy, she's not a big fan of the Skater Dolly. It probably looks like a kiddie Terminator to her. Normally I'd start the review with an unboxing, but there's really not much to the packaging, not unless you like bubble wrap. That's fine though, I don't really need fancy packaging, but this was around $42. Was it worth the money? Here's a shot with the SK-22. See how Bumblebee and the Cybertruck appear in the scene? It's nice. This is the same view with just a still picture. It's easier to do, but it's not as impressive. However, the SK-22 doesn't have to roll in a straight line. The wheels can be angled to set up a curved shot. Underneath the skateboard are two nuts. They can be loosened to change the position of the axle. That can be tricky though, as it's not so easy to get the SK-22 to go perfectly straight. But for this shot here, that's fine. The idea is to roll the camera around the toys. The results look great. Well, I think it looks great. What do you think? You can let everyone know in the comments. It's certainly more dramatic, which can be great for product shots. That's where tip number three can help out a lot. Check the wheels. Even though the wheels have stainless steel ball bearings, only one, maybe two, of the wheels were rolling freely. I had to loosen the screws to allow the wheels to roll. The SK-22 worked a lot better after that. I'm looking forward to seeing if this change helps with future Photix TV videos, as now the SK-22 glides across the table. And even though this camera gizmo is a bit expensive, it feels like it's built to last. At first I thought, How hard could it be to build something like this? It's just a bunch of wheels and a board. But if I tried, I think it would cost a lot more than $42, and it probably wouldn't be as good. The way the camera can be positioned is phenomenal. I have no idea how to make this thing. There are a lot of little parts, too. Also, there are threaded holes all over the SK-22. One more thing, though. The handle is... it's okay. It can be useful to push the skater dolly. I am gentle with it, though, as I don't want to bend it. I was watching a different YouTube video about the Vidpro SK-22, link in the description, and it seems that the handle was changed. It looks like the handle is much longer now, extending to about 38 inches. That's almost 1 meter. The handle also has a threaded hole. I used it to mount my iPhone to the handle. This felt like a very dangerous setup. But even if it wasn't, the camera sway was too extreme to be useful. Perhaps this hole is more for convenience, a place to put extra parts. Anyway, that's the Vidpro SK-22 Skater Dolly. Sometimes I feel like I should have gone with something motorized, especially when I'm struggling to move the skateboard smoothly. But this thing reminds me of a cast iron pan. Maybe it does take a little practice and a little more effort, but the SK-22 should last a long time.